Are you tired of sending boring emails without professional signature? Yeah, you heard me right. Really boring emails you send. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to add a signature to your Gmail for free. And with this, you'll be able to create a professional signature. This works for almost every email platform, such as Gmail, Apple Mail, Yahoo Mail, Outlook, and Mailbird. I'm also going to show you how I was able to create this non-boring looking email signature with my name, description of what I do, email address, mobile number, social media handle, and disclaimer in this section. We're going to be using this platform called Signature Hunt. To sign up for an account, simply search for Signature Hunt on Google and click on this link, which is signaturehunt.com. Now this is going to take you to the home page to sign up for an account. To sign up accounts is very simple, and you do not need to make any payment because this is completely free for you to use. Come to this section, input your email address and click on free sign up, or just come here and click on free sign up, and this is going to take you to the sign up page. On the sign up page, you're going to be requested to provide several information such as your first name, last name, email address and password. And then once you're done providing this information, you can come here where it says I have read and agreed to the terms, and then turn on this toggle and then click on create an account. You're going to be sent an email to verify your email address, and once you have done that, you can then start creating your email signature. After verifying your email address, you're going to be taken to your dashboard, and on your dashboard you can create a new signature. If you already do have a signature, you're going to see them in this section. Click on create a new signature. So once you click on this, it's going to ask you for a signature name. Provide a signature name. The signature name is going to be the name you're going to see on your signature profile, but since I already do have a signature, I'm not going to go create a new one. I'm going to be using the one in my profile to show you how I was able to create my email signature. On your signature page, you're going to see templates, personal information, business info, design, call to action, and disclaimer. You can move within this to make changes to your signature, and automatically any changes you make is going to be saved and backed up, so you don't have to worry about your signature changes not being saved. So in this section, you are going to see several templates that you can select from, and they do have single column, which if you click on them, it's going to show you a preview of what the signature looks in this section. So all you just have to do is select which of them that you prefer the most. But currently for this signature, I am using the vertical 2, which is this one you are seeing in this section. So in the personal information section, here you'll be able to provide a profile image, which is the image you're seeing here, and then you can make changes to the profile picture with your name, which is the name that is going to appear in this section, your job title, you can specify your job title, department, and then your email address. All this information are what you're going to see in this section. Your mobile number, you can provide as many mobile number as you want. To add a mobile number, you can simply click on the plus sign and then you'll be able to add mobile numbers. If you do not want a particular information which has been filled in the template in this section, all you just need to do is come to this section and click on the minus sign to delete. And if you want a particular information to be totally removed, you can come here and then click on clear. Once you do this, it's going to take it out of here. In the business information section, you can put your business logo. If you choose to put a business logo, you can come to show placeholder logo and click on this toggle. Now once you upload an image for your business, it's going to appear below your profile, but if you do not want this, you can turn off the toggle. Company name, address, all are going to be provided in this section. You can also add your personal address if you want to and link to your business website. And below this, you're going to see the social media. The social media are the icons you are currently seeing below the mobile number, such as Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, YouTube. And if you want to add more, you can click on the plus sign to add whichever social media that you are interested in adding, and the link and the icon is automatically going to be placed in this section. In the design section, you're going to have access to customize your template to your desired color. Here you'll be able to do things such as vertically align your image. You can click on the toggle to do that. You can swap profile image and logo. That is if you want the profile image to be at the bottom and the logo to be at the top. You can show icons. If you do not want the icons to show, you can take it out. That is only going to affect your email address, mobile number, and your business address. But if you wanted to show, you can leave the toggle on. Here is for the icon type, so you can click on this to select an icon type for your email. You can also do things such as select social media icon, show dividing line, which is the line you can see here. So if you were to take that out, you won't see that line again. The theme color, icon color, the social media icon color, title color, text color, link color, font color, size color, spacing, separate website created with signature HOND. If you click on this, you're going to see this logo in this section, which is a created with signature HOND logo. It's free and you do not need to pay to be able to remove that. With a call to action, you can add a call to action by uploading an image. And the disclaimer is what you can see in the bottom in this section. So you can make changes to the text from here. So once you have successfully customized your email signature, the next step is to export it. To export your email signature, you want to come to install signature and click on this. You can select which of the email platform that you want to use for your email signature. So personally, I use Gmail. Click on Gmail and then you're going to get this. So all you need to do is come to this section and click on copy signature. And once you have copied signature, come to your email address. And when you are sending email, I'm going to take this out. You can come here and just paste. And that was how I was able to create this awesome looking email signature. So thank you guys for watching and I hope you found this video helpful. If you did find this video helpful, do make sure to subscribe to this channel and have that post notification bell turned on for more content like this. And don't forget to like and share this video. I hope to see you guys in my next video.